Let's talk about view sets. At the beginning of the last section, I mentioned that the Django REST framework offers two classes that help us write the logic for our API. The API view and the view set. In the last section, I introduced you to the API view. And in this section, I'm going to teach you how to use the view set. So what are view sets? Just like API views, view sets allow us to write the logic for our endpoints. However, instead of defining functions which map to HTTP methods, view sets accept functions that map to common API object actions, like list for getting a list of objects, create for creating new objects, retrieve for getting a specific object, update for updating an object, partial update for updating part of an object, and destroy for deleting an object. Additionally, view sets take care of a lot of the common logic for us. They are perfect for writing APIs that perform standard database operations. And they are the fastest way to make an API which interfaces with a database backend. So when should you use view sets? Well, a lot of the time, this will come down to personal preference. However, here are some examples of cases when you might want to choose a view set over an API view. For example, if you need to write an API that performs a simple create, read, update, and delete operation on a database model. Or you need a quick and simple API to manage predefined objects. Or maybe you need very little custom logic additional to the view sets features already provided by the Django REST framework. We'll learn more about that one in a bit. Finally, you may want to use a view set if your API is working with a standard data structure. That's a basic overview of the view set. Don't worry if you don't fully understand it at this point. Sometimes you need to see it in action for it to make sense. So, in the following lessons in this section, I'm going to walk you through creating a very basic view set, step by step. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you in the next lesson.